I'm Paul Zego.
I am TJ Kirk.
This is Snap Judgment.
Which,
ooh, we like. That's sassy.
Yeah, we like the title. We don't like the way the word judgment is spelled.
Yeah, if you're out there suffering because of the spelling of the word judgment like we do, we understand, but we like the title more than we hate looking at the word judgment.
Yeah, it just feels like there should be that E,
yeah.
That extra E in there, and it's just not there, and it's okay, whatever. Fine, English language, fine. We're not here to criticize you. We're here to criticize a little film called Murder on the Orient Express.
Yeah, which came out today. And before we get into the meat of that, I'll let you know a little bit about the structure of these going forward. TJ just came up with it. The good,
the bad,
and the ugly.
The good is what was good about the movie. The bad is what was bad about the movie. The ugly is where we save any sort of spoilery talk. So
the first part of this video will be us talking about the good and the bad in a spoiler-free manner to the best of our ability. Yeah. And then the last part of this...
If we let something slip, though, fuck you.
Yeah. Don't call us on it.
Yeah, fuck.
Never call us on it.
Never. Okay. So
what was good?
The good. Kenneth Branagh as a detective... Hercule Poirot.
Hercules. It's Hercules.
Hercules Poirot.
Yeah.
Hercule.
He was good.
He was excellent.
He was the only character that received. Well, hold on. He was good.
Yes, he was good.
I'm already breaking format.
Don't do it. Don't do it. This is positivity time. Okay?
Right.
The camera work.
Yeah. In addition to starring in the film, Kenneth Branagh directs, and some of the choices that he made. The movie was shot really beautifully at times.
Yes.
Really intimately, kind of like those long sweeping shots you see in the trailers, walking down the aisle, were used really effectively multiple times.
Yeah, there was some snappy dialogue here
yeah,
and there.
Yeah.
Some decent dialogue. There was some jokes that actually landed. Didn't really even expect that, but especially in the early part of the movie before you get into the serious murder mystery stuff.
There was good humor in the film, which was nice.
And it's nice. It breaks up the monotony and stuff of, you don't want something that's too dry, too serious. It starts to feel like...
Well, we see a lot of that in these murder mystery whodunit films.
So
it's like
it was
really
nice that
self-serious.
They
this one wasn't.
A little levity here and there.
Yep.
That's it. Now it's time for the bad.
Yep. The bad.
You go ahead.
Yeah.
Start this one off.
Poirot is the only character that receives any kind of character development at all, save for one, but we'll talk about that later. I don't know. It's just, I've never seen a movie so chock full of fucking characters.
Played by great actors.
Played by absolutely fantastic actors across the board. Judi Dench is in this. Fucking Michelle Pfeiffer. Willem Dafoe. Johnny Depp. It's just packed to the gills with these, like, A-list awesome actors. And not one of them is given enough time to develop their character for you to give a shit. So Poirot is the only one that you really want to watch.
Yeah, because he's the only one that's given even any development. You kind of wonder why they got such A-listers to play these little bit roles that had no meat on the bone whatsoever. Another major complaint about the movie, probably the biggest complaint about the movie, honestly, it's a whodunit where, you don't really feel like it's inviting. If you're watching a good kind of whodunit movie... Paul talked about this in the car. You want to talk about the stupid smart balance thing you were talking to me about in the
car?
Yeah.
To do a proper whodunit and engage your audience, you have to make it smart enough that you feel like the detective is needed, but dumb enough so that your dumb ass can actually follow it and make your own, come to your own conclusions. A good whodunit has to invite you to guess whodunit. And I never once in this, every once in a while, because I knew it was a whodunit, I would think, but my mind never once landed on any one person.
Yeah, it doesn't even invite you to, is the problem. You don't really feel super involved in the investigative process. It almost seems like the movie doesn't really care about it. It just kind of seems like it wants to be a character portrait of Poirot, whose name I can't fucking pronounce.
Poirot!
That guy.
Yeah.
It seems like it's way more interested in doing that, and I mean, like, he's an interesting character, but, you know, without the intrigue of the mystery, it kind of just falls apart, you know? It's like Sherlock Holmes is on the case, but you don't care about the case.
Couldn't have said it better myself. I think that's the bad.
Yeah.
Because we can't really go any deeper into any of that without spoiling. So, spoiler alert for anybody who cares.
Yeah, spoiler alert from this point on.
The ugly.
Yeah, the ugly. Welcome to the ugly. And this one truly is ugly.
Yeah. Let's start at the start. The only other character that receives any kind of character development at all in the film is the victim of the murder that Poirot is investigating. So Johnny Depp's character is this kind of slimy businessman, scam artist kind of guy, clearly violent. I mean, he was really the only interesting person on the train. And he's dead within the first 15 minutes.
Yeah, you get one scene that kind of develops him, and it's an interesting scene. It's one of the better scenes in the movie.
Yeah, his first meeting with the detective.
His only meeting.
Yeah.
He dies shortly thereafter.
Right.
You know, they meet, they talk. He tries to buy Poirot off, and Poirot's like, fuck you, I'm not for sale. And it was an interesting little tense conversation, and, you know, it was interesting to watch him try to intimidate the detective, and the detective be basically completely unimpressed with his threats of intimidation and just totally defusing the situation with, you know, bluntness and wit.
And without ever being rude.
Yeah.
But he still fucks him in the end. Like, this whole conversation takes place over a piece of the other guy's cake, and Poirot sits down and digs in, you know, takes the little pieces and bits that he wants, and the whole scene ends with him walking away and saying the cake was delicious.
Yes.
It was a great scene. So he was thanking him, but he was also telling him, fuck you.
Fuck you. It was a great scene, and it made you very interested to see more of Johnny Depp's character, but then he's immediately killed because he's the center of the murder mystery.
And you're left with...
If you had a cast of interesting people... I mean, and you do have a good cast, but you don't have good characters for them to play, so you're just kind of like, okay, this sucks.
They're like murder mystery archetypes. There's the doctor and the mysterious ingenue and the, you know, the older lady that's well beyond her prime but still, you know, actively looking for a man. I mean, it's just all of the countess and the count and the, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
The handmaiden. They're all just kind of these kind of Clue board game archetypes.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And none of them are developed enough for you to care enough about any one of them to pin the murder on them.
Yeah. So here's the spoiler, I guess. Who done it?
Everybody!
They all done it.
Everybody did it! Everybody on the fucking train was part of a massive conspiracy to kill this one dude. Now, this may not be spoiling anybody if you've read the Agatha Christie novel. I don't know if it's done better there or not. I assume it is.
I would
with
think
proper character development, all of this might make sense. But when you're talking about setting up a bunch of Clue fucking villains and then trying to knock us over with they all love each other and they're all centered around the murder of this little girl.
It was actually quite similar to the end of the movie, Clue.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Because that was another, like, they all done it kind of thing.
I mean, maybe Clue was influenced by the Christie novel something. I don't know.
I have not read it. I don't know if it ends the same way. I don't know if the twist is handled better there.
It almost has to be.
I'm sure it probably is. I know it's a well-regarded book. Here, I don't think it was executed well at all. It just kind of comes across as who cares, because you were never invested in the mystery, and just to find out that it just feels like a really cheap cop-out, because, you know, once again, we just never got to know any of these characters, so who cares?
Yeah, and I guess the big ending spoiler of all is that Detective Poirot has some kind of epiphany. And he realizes that there's not just good and bad, that there's this gray area in between, which I totally agree with. But in this case, a bunch of people getting together in a vigilante mob to kill a dude, even if he deserved to you know, be brought to justice or whatever, that's still wrong, right? Vigilante justice is bad, right? So there really isn't any philosophical debate. And watching this guy who's incredibly smart reveal himself to have one when there where there isn't one is kind of a weird way to end the movie.
Yeah. Very strange. I think it was playing with some concepts there that were interesting. Once again, though, I just feel like the fatal flaw of this movie is that they didn't develop these other characters. Maybe the movie needed to be a little longer, actually, to give these characters some room to breathe so that you actually care about this outcome. But yeah, without any investment in anyone, it's very hard to care about the twist. It's very hard to care about the philosophical dilemma. It's very hard to care about any of it. Yeah, I mean, basically, the premise is Johnny Depp's character did some really heinous shit that affected all their lives at one point or another, so they all get together and hatch this plan to board the train, and each one of them takes one stab at him.
Which is like, what?
Which is like, who? What? You know, like, okay, if let's say I hated someone and wanted them dead, even if they fucked my life up, I think I'd be pretty satisfied with, like, hey, we found him. Okay, we'll send someone to kill him. Okay, we did it. Okay, it's done. I don't think I would need to personally go and, like, make sure that every person that had been wronged got a single stab in, you know, like yeah, some kind of weird cult ritual.
Nor do I think that they could have pulled it off, you know, to that extent under the nose of the best detective in the world.
Yeah, so ridiculous. Makes Poirot kind of look incompetent because he didn't catch wind that every single one of these people was fucking guilty. I mean, I don't know. Doesn't work. Like I said, probably handled better in the book. Might have been handled better in some of the earlier adaptations of this material. I don't know. I know it's been made into a film before.
Maybe there's like a director's cut out there
that yeah, maybe
spends more time.
Maybe there's a Kenneth Branagh director's cut that's going to come out that's going to fix these problems. Because really, I think the main problem, once again, is underdeveloped characters. It just fucks everything else up. It's the poison in the movie's veins. I was really excited when I saw the trailer for this one. I really am a big fan of Kenneth Branagh's work. But unfortunately, I gotta say, don't watch it.
Yep, don't watch it. I'm on the same boat. Liked the trailers, and a lot of the most interesting stuff is kind of represented in those trailers, those long sweeping shots and the kind of oppressive, intimate nature of all these people stuck on a train. All that's, you know, good, but none of those characters that you see float by in the trailer ever amount to anything, so.
Yeah, I will say that if Kenneth Branagh wanted to reprise this role with a better movie that had a tighter script, I think he actually does a really good job portraying the character. Loved his mustache. It made me feel insecure about my own, you know, and I was so proud.
He does have a double-decker mustache in this movie.
Don't watch it.
Don't watch it. And, if you like this, like and subscribe, hit the alerts, follow us on social media and all that shit.
Do it all.
Do it all. Now.
Do it.
Now.
Do it! Please.